She thinks she's all alone, and all her hopes are gone. And so I wrote this song, so she can move along. Well, things were bad, she was in despair. Well, things were bad, and you were never.
In Chinese is nian gao.
And normally the kebako will be in what form and what is this?
Normally the nian gao, the kebako will be in like a very small cylinder form and wrapped by pandan leaf. And it tastes so sweet and very sticky. Normally we need to fry it to make it more crispy. We eat it during every Chinese New Year because it symbolizes that every year we will have a better improvement in our health, in our wealth, in our family. That's all.
Hello, good evening Arina. I'm Syaira. I'm here to complete my second EAC class, which is a documentary on Chinese traditional food, which is Kuih Bako. And as I know, you are one of the mixed Chinese students in UMT. Can I take your time for a while to get some information related to our documentary? Okay, can we start now? Okay, for sure. Can you elaborate a bit about the Kuih Bako?
Kuih Bako also known as Nian Gao, sometimes translated as Year Cake or Chinese New Year Cake. It is a food prepared from glutinous rice and is consumed in Chinese cuisine. It is available in Asian supermarket and health food store. The word nian meaning sticky and gao meaning cake.
When do Chinese usually eating this kuih or kuih bako?
It is traditionally eaten during the Duanwu festival. It is considered good luck to eat during this time because the Nian Gao is a homonym for Higher Year. Other than that, it is eaten during Chinese New Year Eve and Pai Ti Gong. It is an offer to the kitchen god so that his mouth is full with sticky cake. Hence, he is unable to badmouth the human family and also as a bride. Pai Ti Gong, as I said before, it is a prayer to God of Heaven Jade Emperor on the 8th night of Chinese New Year.
Okay, thank you Arina. Thanks for your cooperation. Assalamualaikum.
Yes, assalamualaikum. I am Nina.
Yes.
So I want to introduce you about Kuih Bakul.
Kuih Bako.
That's eaten by Chinese, right?
Oh, so do you mean...
Introduce your name?
Oh, my name Ling Junying. Ling Junying. Do you mean...
So do you know properly that about Kuih Bako?
Kuih Bako, do you mean the Chinese people always eat during the Chinese New Year? Nian Gao? Do you mean that? Kuih Bako?
How it's made?
How it's made? For the ingredient, it has 5 ingredients. The first one is glutinous rice flour. The second one sugar, and the third one is water. And for the last one is banana leaves. So how to make it? It has 9 steps for making the nian gao or kuih bako. Yes. So the first step is soak banana leaf in warm water for at least 30 minutes. After that, cut banana leaf according to the shape of the container or bowl used. The third one for the third step is surround container with at least 2 to 3 layers of banana leaf. And for the fourth one is add plenty of water to the flour and mix well to create a dough. And next, add water and knead the mixture until it turns fruity. So after that, allow the mixture to sit for 15 minutes. Around 15 minutes, more or less. Okay. And for the next one is pour the mixture carefully into the container. So you need to pour very carefully into the container. And for the next step is steam the mixture for around 10 to 12 hours with a piece of cloth over the container. Why we need to use a piece of cloth? So that it can did not have oxygen, cannot improve. So for the last step is the steamed rice cake atau kue bakar lah, nenggau lah, must keep for 2 to 3 days before consuming, because it, after we cook it, so it's very hot, so cannot eat, so need to put for 2 to 3 days is the most time.
So do you know to make kue bakar?
Yes, but I never made it because my parents, my mom. So,
is it delicious? Because I never eat before.
It's delicious because it's very sweet, sweet tea.
So it's easy, right, to do the kueh bakar?
It's not easy.
It's quite difficult.
Yes, the some precaution need to be taken. Yes.
Yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome.
You eat kueh bakar before?
Yes, of course.
Oh, okay. What do you think makes kueh bakar special to you?
Because kueh bakar is very delicious and the shape is very nice. Then it usually eat during Chinese New Year.
Hi, my name is Pang.
I want to ask you about kueh bakar. Is it halal for Muslim to eat kueh bakar? What about the ingredient? There is something that non-haram?
Actually, for my by my knowledge, actually the kueh bakar is halal because it's only made from pulut and Melaka sugar. Chinese never put like pork or wine inside the kueh bakar. Actually halal, but it's halal actually.
So is it halal? Muslim can eat kueh bakar anytime they want.
It should be can.
Alright, that's all I want to ask you. Thank you for your time.
Okay.
Thank you.
Down tonight, 'cause it's always a good time.